धन साहिब श्री गुरु ग्रंथ साहिब जी दी, गुरु खालसा साध संगत साहिब जीओ, वाहेगुरु जी का खालसा, वाहेगुरु जी की फतेह। We're blessed again to be gathered together this time to celebrate the Gurta Gaddi Divas of Sahib Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji Maharaj, the second Guru of the Sikhs, the Ang of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. Because we know when Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji first came to the sanctuary of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji, they were known as Lena, Pai Lena Ji. So we're celebrating their Gurta Gaddi Divas, the day they become the Guru of the Sikhs and they take the light of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji as it is passed on to them, the divine light. So Pai Lena Ji came to the sanctuary of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. Pai Lena Ji actually used to be a worshipper of another way. They would take Sangat to Jawalamukhi one year, and on the way they'd heard of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji and they came to do their darshan. As they were coming to do their darshan on the horse, an old person came and carried them and brought them to the house where Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji was. That old person, as Pai Lena Ji saw from their eyes, was actually Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji themselves. They said to Pai Lena Ji as they brought the horse that Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji is in the house. Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji went round the back and sat in the house. When Pai Lena Ji went inside, they realized that the person who came forth to bring them was Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji themselves, and they begged for forgiveness. But Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji asked them their name. They said, "My name is Lena." And Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji says, "That's right, tusi Lena. You are to take, main dena, I am going to give." They've already mentioned that they're about to give, or they will give, the Gurta Gaddi, the divine light, to Pai Lena Ji, who then becomes Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji. We also know from history that it was Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji themselves who'd blessed the parents of Pai Lena Ji when Pai Lena Ji came to this world. They'd already visited their parents at that time. So Pai Lena Ji stayed in the sanctuary of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji at Kartarpur Sahib, the place which is now just on the border of Pakistan and India. They stayed at that place, always completing the hukam of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. At the end of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji's times, they were testing the Gursikhs to see who would be worthy. They dressed themselves in old and ragged clothes. They got dogs with them. They had a stick and they would hit Sikhs and say, "Go away, run away." They would throw maya and money, and some of those Sikhs would pick up the money and run away. As they were testing the Sikhs, four Gursikhs, Pai Sadaran Ji, Pai Pagirath Ji, Baba Buddha Sahib Ji, and Pai Lena Ji themselves were the last four to stay and continue to follow Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji was pajaying everybody, "Run away, I don't need the Sikhs, there is no Sikhi." They're testing them to see how strong their faith is. Will they remain with the Guru no matter if they're being shouted at? Those four Gursikhs remained. Guru Sahib Ji continued, and three of those, Pai Pagirath Ji, Pai Sadaran Ji, and Baba Buddha Sahib Ji, hid behind a bush, but Pai Lena Ji continued. There was a dead carcass under a white cloth. Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji kept saying, "If you keep saying you're a Sikh of mine, will you do anything?" They said, "Yes." They said, "Eat this dead carcass." Pai Lena Ji stood there. Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji said that, "Look, you're not even eating it. You said you'll follow my every hukam." Pai Lena Ji said, "I was waiting for you to tell me which side to start, from the head side or from the feet side." When they lifted up the chadar, it wasn't a dead carcass. It was Kadaha Prasadi Deg, and they were blessed at that point. Baba Buddha Sahib Ji later, at the time of Guru Hargobind Sahib Ji, because they are the greatest Gursikh outside of the Gurus, and Baba Buddha Sahib Ji later explained to Guru Hargobind Sahib Ji when they were asked that the Tej Pratap, the divine light, they couldn't handle the divine light, and that's why those three Gursikhs couldn't handle and continue forward, because it was always meant to be by Lena Ji, who is the second form of Akal Purkh Wahiguru on this earth. So other times, Baba Sri Chand, Baba Lakshmi Das, the sons of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji, they would never necessarily follow the hukam of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. One such time, when Guru Sahib Ji asks for the chadra to be washed, the cloths, the bedcloths to be washed, Pai Lena Ji washes those cloths. Baba Sri Chand and Baba Lakshmi Das don't do that. When a cat brings a dead mouse into the house, Baba Sri Chand is told and Baba Lakshmi Das is to take it out of the house, but they don't, they refuse. They say, "Go get a nokar to do it." Pai Lena Ji at once picks it up and takes it out. So Baba Lakshmi Das and Baba Sri Chand always thought themselves as greater, that the servants could do these deeds, but a Sikh will always do the seva of the Guru, no matter what seva it is. A pot was thrown in the Shappad. Shappad is like the swamp type area in villages that we see. And again, Baba Sri Chand and Pai Lakshmi Das refused to go in. by Lena ji in their clothes, jump straight in there, take out the pot, wash it clean, completely clean, even though their clothes are completely dirty and they're dripping with mud and the swamp water. But the pot is cleaned and given back to Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. Because Mata Salakhani Ji, the mother of Baba Sri Chand and Bhai Lakshmi Das, questioned why Bhai Lena Ji is given all the blessings. And these were times when Guru Sahib Ji showed that our sons don't even follow the command of the Guru. So how are they to be blessed? Bhai Lena Ji is given the Gurta Gaddi. They are blessed and they are given the name Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji Maharaj. They are told to go to Khadur Sahib. But before they go to Khadur Sahib, Baba Buddha Sahib Ji one more time has a shanka, because they know they are the sevadar of the Sikhs, of the Guru. And they have this shanka, the confusion in their mind that Guru Sahib Ji blessed them with everything, but why weren't they given the Gurta Gaddi? So one night, Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji asked Baba Buddha Sahib Ji, what time is it? Is it time to awake? Is it Amrit Vela yet? Baba Buddha Sahib Ji says, it's Addi Raat Hoi Hai. So it's about 6 hours. If we say the night is 12 hours, it's about 6 hours into the night. Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji said, no, it looks like there are only 3 hours left of the night. So basically we've had 3 quarters of the night and there's 1 quarter left, which we should awake for the last 3 hours, which is Amrit Vela. Another time they test again. And each time Baba Buddha Sahib Ji, because they were Siyane, they were blessed as the name of Buddha by Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji because they had great knowledge. And each time Baba Buddha Sahib Ji would look at the stars and say, no, it's Addi Raat, it's halfway through the night. We've still got a few hours before Amrit Vela is. Then another time they asked Bhai Lena Ji. Bhai Lena Ji is asked, what time is it? First Bhai Lena Ji says, it's Addi Raat. But Sri Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji say, no, it looks like it's Amrit Vela, there's 3 hours left. Bhai Lena Ji says, Sat Bachan, whatever Bachan you say is true. If you, the hukam is all yours, Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji, you are the commander of the world, you are Waheguru themselves. If you say there's only 3 hours left of the night and it is now time for Amrit Vela, we should be getting up, then it must be the case, Sat Bachan, you must be right. So even though it was Addi Raat, Bhai Lena Ji was the one who followed the hukam and accepted what Guru Sahib Ji said. That shows us that whatever Guru Sahib Ji tell us to do, whether we think it's right or wrong, whether we think it's for these modern times or for the Western world or for the day and age we live in, we should always listen, believe and follow the hukam of our Guru, whatever it is, because we should always say Sat Bachan to it. So Bhai Lena Ji was always saying Sat Bachan, and that's why they were worthy of being the Guru of the Sikhs. But we also know that they came to this world as the Guru, and they showed us the way actually by listening, believing and following the hukam of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. So today we're celebrating the Gurta Gaddi Divas of Sahib Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji Maharaj. Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji Maharaj, like I said, their name was changed to Angad. They are the limb, the ang of Guru Nanak Dev Sahib Ji. They are one and the same. They are the form of Waheguru. We're celebrating their Gurta Gaddi Divas. There's no slight on Baba Buddha Sahib Ji, because it was just the hukam. They showed us through the Sakhiya that Bhai Lena Ji was the worthy one. Baba Buddha Sahib Ji, though, is the greatest Guru Sikh outside of the Gurus, but we're remembering and celebrating Sri Guru Angad Dev Sahib Ji today. If I've made any mistakes, I beg for forgiveness. Let us hope and pray that Guru Sahib Ji can bless us all. Deho Sajjana Si Sri and Jehovah Sahib Ji may likha kat ehna shuti akhen khen poolan haar, baksan haar baksala, nanak paar utar, Waheguru Ji ka khalsa, Waheguru Ji ki fateh.
Please like, comment, subscribe and share this video to spread the message of Sikhi. Make your dasvand safala and donate so we can create more content like this. The link is in the description below.